CEO of Open the Books, Adam Andrzejewski, tells One American News that the cost of illegal immigration at the southern border has hit a record of at least $20 billion in just the last 2 years. One America's John Hines has more from Washington.
The Biden administration spent a whopping $20 billion on refugee resettlement in 2 years, according to the government watchdog group OpenTheBooks.com, which has uncovered these numbers. And OpenTheBooks.com CEO Adam Andrzejewski is with us. Adam, we've got a record number of illegal immigrants, illegal immigration coming over the southern border, and now a huge $20 billion number for refugee entrant assistance. Is this a mere coincidence, sir?
No, the all-time high in illegal entrants has led to an all-time high in taxpayer funding and support once these folks get in our country. And so look, last year alone, you had 2.5 million illegal encounters at the border. Most of it was at the southern border. Most of the illegal entrants, one-third of them actually are from Mexico as a nation of origin. The other nations of origins that come across the border are from Guatemala, Honduras, Colombia, Cuba. So you've got Mexico, the Americas, Central and Southern South America, plus the Caribbean nations. Those are the people coming across our southern border.
Is this through just the administration of children and families, this office, this is a part of, I gather, Health and Human Services, this administration of children and families? Is that, break this out for us, I guess, is that what I'm saying, is that just with this one agency or is this a number of agencies?
So trying to put a taxpayer cost on the surge is very difficult. So we took one agency, a sub-agency of Health and Human Services called the Office of Refugee Resettlement, and we found a $20 billion taxpayer cost just over the course of the last two fiscal years. And last year, the cost jumped in 1 year by $2 billion. And so, John, let's put that into context. The left went absolutely crazy when Donald Trump in 2016 promised a border wall at $8 billion. Next estimates were $12 and $15 billion. This was $20 billion over the course of the last 2 years with no end in sight.
So your point is that even if the southern wall costs, you know, $5, $6 billion, whatever, it's actually a pretty good deal in the end? Is that what you're saying?
Well, 100%, because then you don't have the migrant crush and crisis at the border with the unintended consequences. John, incredibly, there's been 260,000 unaccompanied children come across the border. That's unaccompanied. These are kids less than 18 years of age that come across without a parent or guardian. And so then they have to be sponsored into the system. And this agency that we're talking about, the Office of Refugee Resettlement, they've actually lost track of 85,000 of those unaccompanied kids.
So this is from one agency within the Department of Health and Human Services. Is it conceivable that the total cost of the southern border illegal immigration is more than $20 billion in the last 2 years?
Well, 100%. And there's a tail on all of these expenditures. For example, there's been an ever-expanding mandate of the perks for an illegal entrant through this Office of Refugee Resettlement. Here are just a list of some of the perks that are given today. They get emergency housing support. They get a work authorization and a public benefits application with many benefits after that, including free cell phones. You get a medical screening, school enrollment. You get cultural orientation. You get mental health services and legal referrals as well.
What is the trend here? This trend has been changing since 2020. What has been the direction? What have you found with regards to the trend line?
So the mandate at this agency, they're ever expanding it to encompass more and more people. So for example, now nearly everyone coming over the border, they claim asylum. So they get the full suite of the largesse from the American taxpayer and all the benefits that traditionally were only available to a very narrowly defined subset of people.
Adam Andrzejewski, CEO of OpenTheBooks.com. Sir, it's always a pleasure to talk to you, always very informative. Thank you for joining us on One America News, sir.
For all our viewers asking where One America News is heading in the future, we would like to introduce you to OAN Live. OAN Live is the best way to stay up to date on all of the hard-hitting, straight-shooting, national and international headlines. And the best part is, OAN Live is only $4.99 per month. All the credible, honest, unbiased reporting One America News offers at a fraction of the cost of cable. Just go to OANN.com to easily sign up for OAN Live and stay informed.